Hi, welcome to This Is My Architecture. My name is Andrea, and I'm here with Pedro from Orangetheory Fitness. Hi, Pedro. Welcome to the show.
Thank you, Andrea.
So what do you guys do?
Orangetheory Fitness was founded about 11 years ago, and we are boutique fitness studios. Coach-led classes last about an hour, 20 or so members, and we are a global company.
Excellent. So we're going to talk about OTlive. Tell our viewers, what is that?
Yes, right as the pandemic hit, our studios were forced to shut down. Mm-hmm. In order to keep our users engaged, we came up with this digital experience where we provide them virtual classes to keep that coach-member relationship going through the times that the studios were closed.
Wonderful. This runs on AWS. Let's walk through a use case. Let's dive straight to it. I'm a studio member. Mm-hmm. What do I do first?
Yes, so as a member, you would book a class like you normally would, mm-hmm. except these are, you know, these are marked as virtual classes.
Okay.
Once you're booked for the class, you will receive an email with a link to where the class will be held.
Okay.
And once you get to that link, you will then use Cognito to authenticate and to let you into the class. The application will then use API Gateway with Lambda to retrieve class information that will be provided to the member.
Okay, from Aurora. Wonderful. Okay, so now, you know, I'm authenticated. How do I establish connection with the coach? What does the coach need to undergo?
Yes, so the coach follows a similar process. Mm-hmm. They just have a different link, and they use Cognito again to authenticate, go through API Gateway, and follow the same flow to retrieve class information from Aurora. And they provide a lobby experience for our members until the class has started.
I see. Now, you know, both are authenticated. As a studio member, you're going to join a class. You have been assigned a coach. How do they establish connection between themselves?
Yes. So we rely heavily on the Chime SDK for this work. So we use the Chime SDK to provide the video experience that's going from the member to the coach and back. The coach can see video tiles with each of the members, mm-hmm. and the members can see a view not only of the coach, but we also mix in video that is recorded showing each of the exercises that they need to be doing at any given time, as well as the music that goes with the class.
I see. That's, so you're using the Chime SDK to establish, you know, video connection. What else are you gathering in that interaction?
So during the class, our members wear our heart rate monitors. And from those heart rate monitors, mm-hmm. we collect heart rate data every second. That data is sent using the WebSocket functionality that Chime SDK provides to the coach. And so the coach has a view of heart rate information about every single one of our members during the class.
And so this is real time.
Yes.
How do you ensure that, you know, low latency, this full-on real-life, real-time experience? How do you achieve that?
Yes, so we're relying on the Chime service to provide us that low-latency experience, and it is available in every region that we need it to be.
I see, almost like an edge.
Yes, and it's also available on the edge for improved performance.
Awesome. So walk us through, what do you do with that data? You know, aside from just that in-studio experience.
Right. So during the class, like I said, the coach is able to see the heart rate information of the member. Now, mm-hmm. that data is also being sent over Kinesis into our data lake, second by second, mm-hmm. right? There's also another experience, which is once the workout completes, where the summary information for that workout, it's also sent over Kinesis and down into our data lake. We also send it, again, through our REST APIs and landed in Dynamo so that it can be retrieved at any time by the members using our mobile application and they can review the classes.
Oh, wonderful. So let's talk about scale. I'm sure you're hosting many virtual classes. Walk us through, how does that work here? You know, hosting multiple classes, I'm sure, is nationwide. How do you accomplish that?
Yes, so we are a cloud native, serverless first mm-hmm. Shop. So we have been able to rely on API Gateway, Lambda, DynamoDB, Aurora, S3, Kinesis, all of these managed serverless services for scaling not only up as our demand goes up, but as down as well as demand has flattened out and now continue to recover as our membership comes back.
Wonderful. And what does the future hold, Pedro?
Well, this started as a short-term project to give our members another option while the studios were closed. But it's become part of our member experience. Yeah. It's going to grow globally. And not only are we going to provide the virtual real-time interactions, but we're also going to provide our members with the library of video on demand, so different exercises and different experiences that they'll be able to take advantage of.
Great, this is a very interesting architecture. Thanks for walking us through this OTlive virtual classes, and you accomplished that through Chime SDK connections between the coach and the studio members, and do it serverless and be able to scale. Thank you so much
You're
again
welcome.
Being on the show. And thank you for watching This Is My Architecture.